Okay, so this is going to be 30 creepy videos from TikTok. If you want to at me in any of your scary TikToks that you find or creepy or whatever, usually just like ghost kind of stuff or paranormal seeming stuff, those would be cool to have in a video like this. But yeah, so the first one I'm going to play and whatever, so yeah.
Put a finger down if you were kidnapped from your best friend's front yard when you were 15 by a guy who didn't look creepy or scary, but he put a gun to the side of your neck and told you to get in a plastic container in the back seat of his car. He took you to his apartment where he drugged you, held you captive, and sexually assaulted you for over 18 hours before you were able to escape while he was sleeping. You undid the restraints tied around your wrists and your legs, and you ran out the door. You found some guys who took you to law enforcement. Law enforcement then was able to identify him from the information that you had memorized from his apartment. He was obviously gone when law enforcement got back to his apartment, though, so he was on the run for 3 days before his sister turned him in. When his sister turned him in, there was a car chase that ended in him shooting himself, and whenever law enforcement went and searched his apartment, they found information that led them to believe that he may have been involved in previous murders in Virginia. Turns out he was involved in those, and the solving of those murders led to you getting reward money, which put you through college, and also led to you becoming law enforcement.
What even? That was a lot. So that was basically, I guess, a real serial killer story kind of thing. And I guess they went through a bunch of stuff there. But yeah, that's like, what the fuck? It's kind of like, it's good that they found out that he was involved in other things, so they know at least someone who was a part of other stuff, so at least those other ones can get solved too. So, or they can try to solve other ones. So, at least there's that part. At least something good came out of that part. And then I guess they also got to have money to go through college from that too. So that's another good thing that came out of that. But of course, overall, just shitty situation there. So. Yeah, I don't know. Even if something good comes from something, it's still shitty to go through it. Even if, like, oh, you got money to go to college and other crimes got, like, you know, solved or are gonna get solved or whatever, like, it's still shitty. So, yeah, I don't know. That's crazy, though. That is actually kinda, yeah, creepy and crazy and scary. But, anyways, gonna go to the next one now. Okay, so the second one didn't work. So I guess like maybe they privated the video or it got deleted or something, but gonna go to the third one. So this might be more like 29 videos instead, depending on if all the other ones work too. But here's the next one, and so it's a picture of someone before they got killed, I guess, which you guys can read it and we'll play the video here too, so then you know what's happening. But yeah, that sounds really weird. But okay. What is it now? Is it like they have a weapon there or something or whatever? Are they holding? Hang on. Are they holding a weapon there? Or is that the person? I think that might be like the person there in the picture, and so it's like the actual picture of someone. Yeah, I don't really know who it is there, but I guess if you wanna know exactly all the stuff there for that person, then I can, I guess, just look up that if you want. I don't really know, but yeah, that is kinda like, you know, pictures of like the pictures have crazy or scary things behind them. I actually wanna make a video about pictures of like before like something horrible happened, or like pictures with like a horrible backstory on it. So Yeah, I do have like a whole thing of pictures that I'm gonna put in a video or two. So if you guys want to see that video, I guess you can subscribe and maybe comment that you want to see that video or a couple videos like that. So yeah, I like those videos, but also those videos are scary, so I don't know, but I want to do a video like that. So okay, so next one here. So is this just some crazy stuff happening, I guess? I don't know. Hit play, see what's happening.
See, when I read that, everything is true.
Okay, so what's going on? Showing up in the background of various historical scenes for
See, when I read
decades.
that, everything is true. See, when I read that, everything is true.
Yeah. So it's like they're involved in some shit there. They're involved in that trash. That's fucked up. You know, is anyone surprised that, you know, higher up people, and doesn't matter. I don't think it matters what people they are. Like, a lot of people in power seem to be like greedy and horrible and just absolute garbage people. Like, I don't think it matters like what religion or country or anything. Like, it seems like a lot of people in power for most places are just doing it because they're shitty and trashy and they want to control people and whatever. So yeah, that's, you know, not surprising. If someone is like a higher up and then they do some horrible shit, or they're involved in some horrible shit, but yeah, I don't know. Whatever. So this one is houses with creepy secret rooms, I guess. I don't know. I guess there's hidden rooms and
Yeah.
whatever.
Mortgage foreclosure inspection.
Is that pool cover?
Taking a look at the house. It's got a little bit of damage on the inside, but it's from a prior claim, so there's not anything we can do.
There's
Then
a
I come back
window.
around the house and I notice this.
Why is there a
There's no
window?
window there.
The fuck?
Cool. First, you know, the stairs. It's a lot. But I was under the house in that crawl space right there. Well, that's where the crawl space ends. There is no opening into that. What does that go to?
Yeah, that's weird that there's just a random window down there. Like, why did they put that there? Where does it go? I wonder if they could somehow, like, look through the window. I wonder if, like, they have more videos about it, so I might check out their TikTok to see if they have more videos about it, actually. But yeah, I hate that. Especially if it's like an older house or something, or an older building, then they have like a secret thing, and it's like, I hate it. I hate that. Okay, so this one is another thing about more creepy secret rooms, I guess. So, is this from the same person? I don't know. I don't think it's from the same person, so it's just a different thing that has creepy rooms that are like hidden or whatever.
See, this
So
is my brother's room. This really like gross smell has always been in here, so we got a guy to kind of check it out. This is the side of my house. This is my brother's room. And basically, the guy started in this really gross storage room. And he found a hole in the wall and he climbed through, and it led to two rooms that we had no idea existed. So
I
then we
hate it.
found out that those two rooms connect to my brother's closet, and we had no idea. We took the shelves off, and there's this really loose wall, so we used a hanger to open it. The door was unlocked, so this is the first room, and this is the second room, and that's the hole.
The guy covered the floors with bleach because there's dirt and blood, so I'm not gonna go in.
Oh.
But yeah.
Why is there blood?
So like for part two.
Okay, so I guess there's a part two. So if you wanna watch part two, then you can go to their TikTok. But they said there is dirt and blood on the floor. That's especially since it's like a hidden room behind like the closet, and then like the there's a secret little thing in the storage room to get in and out. That's just, I wonder if that little hole in the storage room could have maybe been like for feeding someone, maybe like putting food through that little tiny window. I don't know if anyone could fit through the window, especially since it's so high up on the ground. But like they could maybe drop food from there and whatever. So it's like if they had someone trapped in there, what the fuck? Yeah, that's like, why is there blood in there? And also it smells bad from that too. Not great. That's not great. And so this one is a tour of a creepy abandoned mine. So that actually sounds cool, but also I wouldn't want to go in any mines or anything because they can collapse and you can either get smushed or get stuck and not be able to get enough oxygen. Either way, you're gonna be dead. So I'm just like, eh, I wouldn't want to go in there. So I guess let's play the video.
After hiking for about 2 hours with no cell reception and in the middle of a storm, I had finally found the mine. This place is definitely top five scariest things I've ever seen. I did the logical thing, grabbed my little handy dandy flashlight thingy, and I climbed inside even though it said not to. Keep in mind, I'm completely alone and haven't had cell reception for 2 hours at this point. I heard some weird noises coming from way, way down the mine, but I figured it was just probably like the rocks or something. The graffiti on these old support beams, as you can see, kind of made me a little bit paranoid. It just said a bunch of really creepy stuff like watch your back, shame, and there was even 666 with upside down crosses. That's a good sign, right? As I got further, I found where I was hearing the noises, and the cave opened up way bigger than it was before. There was a small creek running through the middle, so I decided I was going to follow the creek and see where it led. Come back and I'll show you the final part.
Again, it's just a part two thing. And it's like the graffiti, a lot of people do that stuff where they're like, turn away or turn back, or they write some whatever, something about like Satan or something. Which it's, you know, once you've seen that stuff enough times, it's kind of expected. So you probably shouldn't think too much about it, because there's like everywhere where there's graffiti in like tunnels, abandoned places, whatever, there's always gonna be something about like 666 or whatever, upside down cross or anything. So yeah, and also those things aren't really just like connected to Satan necessarily, like they also have different meanings. So you know, again, you shouldn't think too much about it, because it doesn't really mean anything. So people are just fooling around, messing with people with the turn your back, turn away or turn back or whatever, stuff like that. So it's probably just some teenagers being dumb. So, you know, whatever though. So this one seems kind of crazy. Like they're going through whatever documents, and apparently it's supposed to be from like the CIA or whatever, which how would you even get that? So it seems really weird that they can go and like just see these. But yeah, I guess I'll play the video though. Just seems really weird how you got these things.
Okay, so this document blew my mind. We found this from the Discord group, and this was done in 84 after the Jupiter exploration. So they obviously had enough results where they thought it was successful. So they decided to go back to 1 million years BC on the planet Mars. He mentioned seeing a perception of shadow people, very tall and thin, but only a shadow, as if they were there and now they're not there anymore. And then he says, go back to a period of time when they were there. And he says, I get like a lot of static on the line and everything. It's breaking up. And he says, just report raw data. And he just says, I just keep seeing very large people. They appear very tall, very large, wearing some strange clothes. He says they dress in all, like, light silk, but not flowy. It's, like, cut to fit. He asks them to ask about them. They say they're ancient people, and they're dying. It's past their time. And then they asked him to ask the individual if he knows who he is. I think he just perceives me as a hallucination.
The fuck? That just seems like something someone would say for, like, a really weird dream or some, like, I don't know, if someone was on drugs and they're, like, high or something. Like, that just seems some weird dream, some fever dream or something like that. I don't know. Like, what the fuck? What even... Like, if, but also, I don't know, like, if they were actually in space and they were, like, saying this stuff from, on, like, Mars or whatever, like, could there just be something with the air that they're breathing, with their tanks and stuff? Because, like, I mean, obviously they can't breathe air on Mars, because, you know, there's no plants there, so they have to have their oxygen tank things. So I don't know. maybe they were hallucinating. I think they said like the other creature said that they thought he was a hallucination, but maybe it was the dude that was having a hallucination. I don't know, whatever though. But like, you know, if they did actually see aliens or whatever, would anyone be surprised? Because, like, we can't be the only people here in space and whatever. Like, even though, like, we know more about space than we do our own oceans, space is so massive and whatever, and there's other planets that are similar to Earth, so... I don't know why anyone would really be questioning aliens, even though, like, we haven't seen any, and we haven't really seen anything to really support it. But, like, do you really think we'd be the only people in space, or, like, the only creatures in space? Like, you think Earth is the only thing that's holding life? I don't know. I don't think we're the only people in space or the only creatures here on a planet. Like, we have humans and other animals here and plants. Then, like, shouldn't there be other humans and animals and stuff? Or not humans, but, like, other life, other beings on some other planets or something like that? I don't know, but, you know, you kind of... Whatever. Okay, this one is a ranonauting video. I've seen multiple things about the ranonauting and whatever. I kind of want to do it, but I don't know. But, like, I've seen other people do it. And I've seen a couple TikToks where they found creepy stuff as they're doing it. So I'm gonna play this one here and see what they found that was possibly creepy.
Like to be spooked, listen! Rando Knotting. It's an app you download, it's called Rando Knot. What is it? Rando Knot gives you QRPs, quantum random points. What are quantum random points, bitch? Let me explain that to you. Quantum random points are high points of energy and power near you. Attractors have a lot of energy, voids don't have as much. So if you really want to get spooked, you go to attractors. This app gives you the location of attractors and voids, and then you go. There's an entire subreddit where people explain the weird stuff that happens at these points. People report paranormal activity, leaving the simulation or reality, feeling like you're tripping on drugs, spiritual awakening. But the number one thing reported that they...
Okay, I guess that video wasn't long enough, but yeah, they found some weird stuff in the woods, I guess, where there's, like, a little shed-looking thing and some random little stuff there, but yeah, a lot of people find really weird stuff when they're using this app and like exploring and whatever. But if you don't really understand what it is, you kind of just do the app, do the whatever thing where it finds a spot for you to go. And it's not always the exact little thing to go to. You can go like a few like yards around it and find other stuff that's like weird or creepy or whatever you're trying to find. So yeah, it's kind of a just a random little thing. It even has the rando at the start of the name of the app, so it's a random thing that it'll give you. So yeah, you'd have to go like watch, I don't know, some of their YouTube videos about that to actually like understand exactly what's going on. I don't really know exactly how to explain it, but yeah, hopefully I kind of explained it well enough, but I don't know. I don't think I really can. You'd have to see it for yourself. So this one is, I guess their dog found a body. So yeah, that's gonna be really weird and crazy, which, you know, it's a dog. Of course it found something because it can probably smell it from quite a ways away, since usually dogs have good noses and whatever, so.
Hey, something traumatic happened that changed my life, check.
Oh my god. Oh.
Wait, oh my god! That's a spy! Ruby!
Oh yeah, that's, so I guess they thought he had a stick and it had like probably just whatever stuff on it. Like, when I saw that, I kinda like, bro, that's not a stick. And they were like laughing and whatever because they thought the dog was cute, I guess. But I was kinda just like, bro, that's not a stick. That's definitely not a stick. Maybe they just didn't look at the thing itself. And so they didn't really know. But like, I don't know, like, why would the dog, I mean, dogs do like chewing on bones, but like, that one looked old. But also, that looked kind of long, so like, was it a person then? I don't think it would be a person. That looked a little too long to be a person, unless it was just a really tall person. But like, it's probably like a deer or something instead, but I don't know, whatever. I don't know. Could be anything, really, if it's in the woods, I guess. So, this one is a creepy town clown motel. Which, you know, some people are scared of clowns. I'm not really scared of clowns, but I do, like, think clowns are kind of weird, but I don't think they're really creepy, but some people are scared of it, so I don't know, whatever though.
We are at the Clown Motel in Tonopah,
very
Nevada.
Low.
It is said to be the scariest motel.
Scariest motel.
In okay. America, with a cemetery right there.
There's a cemetery See? There? What the heck, why is there a cemetery there? Well, I guess if there's a cemetery, maybe it's haunted, and that might be why it's scary. Because if you're not afraid of clowns, you might get haunted, and that can be kind of scary, so, I don't know. But, I guess if you're not scared of clowns, and you're brave enough to go in there, even if there's some, like, creepy looking clown stuff, then, I don't know, try to see if you can get some ghosts there, though. So, this one is, I guess, another random outing thing or whatever, the Randonautica app or whatever, and they find a creepy town or ghost town or whatever. So I guess I'm gonna play this.
Okay, so this Randonauting app just brought us to this creepy town, and honestly, when we saw this, we should have turned around and left. We continued up the mountain though, and there's always abandoned cars and nobody around. at this point, we're definitely trespassing. We couldn't even really turn around at this point because the road was so narrow and it was such a steep drop-off on the other side. We were kind of intrigued at how creepy this was, even though it was getting dark really quick, and next thing we know, the sun had gone down and the moon came out, giving it just more of a creepy vibe. But we had the pin pulled up, we were so close to it, and this happened.
What the hell?
This. We're the only ones around, and a random rock falls. I think that was a sign that we should leave, but we kept going. Everything about this place was just giving me really bad vibes, and when I looked into here and saw this, as soon as I realized it's some sort of face, we took off running. I don't know what it is with this town, why there's all these abandoned cars, and no people, and mannequins in the window, but I'm deleting this app.
Yeah, that's like, what the fuck? There's like a mannequin or animatronic or something in the window there, but yeah, that's weird. I mean, like, abandoned places can be cool, but that's kind of weird, especially since it was dark there. They should have probably just turned around and left. So, yeah, but they wanted to keep going. So, I don't know. I think if it started getting dark out, I wouldn't want to be out there just because, you know, there's that steep hill, and it's like, you don't want to be driving on that road when it's dark, and you could have it fall off. So, yeah, that was dangerous of them to do. They could have fallen or tripped over something, somehow gotten hurt, and that would have just made it even more horrible for them. So don't do that. Try to avoid that stuff. So yeah, that app can bring you to some crazy stuff. It's just, if you ever seen other videos of that kind of thing, it's crazy. Here is another Randonaut video, and then it says, always Randonaut with friends. So yeah, that's another thing, like, you should probably do it with at least another person or a couple other people, just to, you know, if you get hurt or something, or if you get lost, then you at least have someone else with you. I guess you wouldn't want to get lost with someone else and doom someone else too, but yeah, you know. If something happens to one person, then the other person can try to do something, though, so at least there would be that.
So after a group of teens found a dead body through this app, I thought it'd be a good idea to download it. I read all of the terms and conditions and even researched it a little bit just so I knew what I was doing. So I enter in my address and I get this location. I was like, I know where that is. It's about 5 minutes away, so I drive out there. Mind you, it's midnight, I haven't charged my phone, and I didn't tell anyone where I was going, so I'm stupid. It's not what happened when I went there that scared me, it's what happened when I got home. So, you know, I get to that area, and I didn't see anything, but then I saw a cop car coming my way. The lights were flashing, the sirens were on, so I booked it, I was out. So I go home, and I pull in my driveway, and a white truck pulls up behind me.
Someone just fucking pulled up behind me. I'm literally sitting in my driveway.
Yeah, that's weird. That's really weird. At least nothing happened when they were out doing the thing, but yeah, that's like, what the fuck? Why is there just a random car sitting there behind them? Like, what the fuck? Yeah, I don't know. So this one is scary old man yelling at kids protesting for BLM. So I guess this person doesn't like that they're supporting Black Lives Matter, I guess? I don't know. I have to play the video.
Radio, overprivileged little kids. You step 1 foot on that fucking property, you guys are gonna be in some deep serious shit, is that understood?
We're not bothering you, I don't
give a fuck. Don't sit there and lip jack me, because this is your guys' fucking problem.
We didn't
you guys
say
are a bunch of
fucking
yep. See, you guys are a bunch of overprivileged little shits.
Yeah,
you guys need the shit knocked out of every single one of you.
You're threatening kids.
Threatening kids. You know what? You guys need your fucking asses beat, is what you fucking.
You're a fucking idiot. Go mow your lawn.
Fuck you.
Okay.
Fuck you.
We are being peaceful.
Public property.
Well,
step foot on it, I will come.
We're not going to. To go mow your fucking lawn.
I was your parent, I'd be fucking embarrassed as
great.
Fuck.
Yeah, it's the entire video. It's just like, this guy's a fucking idiot. Oh my god, you're standing on public property, just standing there. How dare you? Like, you know this dude just hates kids. Like, if he has kids of his own, that's like, why the fuck did you have kids? Like, if you don't like kids, don't have kids. Like, I don't like kids. I'm not gonna have kids ever. And I mean, I'm not gonna do what this bitch does and like go to random kids on the street and just start like yelling at them and shit. Like, I don't care to do that. I just don't want kids. I just don't really care to take care of them or anything. So it's just like, how about you just leave people alone though? Like, yeah, that's just, it's fucking stupid. And telling them that they should get beat up. Someone, like, hopefully they could get, maybe a restraining order or something on that guy to just stay away from them, because I wouldn't be surprised if he did do something, and yeah, that's horrible. So this one says the mystery machine on the whatever there, and mystery soda machine kind of thing, I guess. I don't know, I think I've seen something like this before. Maybe I've seen this video, I don't know. Probably, since it looks familiar.
This Seattle soda machine is a mystery. No one knows who installed it, no one knows who stocked it, and no one knows who collected the money. Since the late 90s, it sold soda at 75 cents, and it began with one mystery button that gradually grew, and it would dispense rare sodas or sodas that weren't even in circulation. In January 2018, it raised its price to $1, and at that point, all of the buttons were mystery buttons. And in June 2018, it just disappeared. On its Facebook page, it said, "Going for a walk, need to find myself, maybe take a shower even." And since then, it's been photoshopped into pictures from around the world.
I won't really say that's necessarily creepy, but that is weird. Just to have a random soda machine just sitting there and no one knows where it came from and no one knows where it's gone. Yeah, that's weird. It's just a weird whatever, not really creepy to me. Maybe a little bit, but mostly just weird. So this one is supposed to be a abandoned penthouse, I guess. It looks like a freaking hotel. So I guess play it. Hopefully this isn't copyright. I'm guessing it would be copyright, but yeah, there's a lot of whatever stuff here. Is that a pool? That was nasty. There's a little vending machine in there too. There's like hair dryers or hair things in there too. Yeah, that's, there's like, I guess, expensive stuff in there still, even though it's abandoned and people could just go in there and like take stuff, like that whole entire soda vending machine thing. I guess it would be hard to take that out of there if it was like there were stairs and stuff, but I don't know, someone could somehow figure out a way to get big things like that out. I wouldn't be surprised if someone somehow found a way to do that, but yeah, that's, like, there's so many floors and stuff, it's crazy. Also, like, big buildings, also, like, hospitals and stuff, and then there's so many abandoned hospitals, it's crazy. And it's always interesting to, like, see abandoned stuff like that. So, this one is supposed to be a Death Premonitions from Siri thing. So I guess Siri's telling them that something bad is gonna happen. I don't know, I guess.
No, So there's this picture on my dad's phone, and it's really scary, and they think it's the last thing he's gonna see before he dies.
This just showed up on his phone out of nowhere. It says January 30th, 2027, and no one knows where this picture was taken from.
The hell?
Or what it's of. He doesn't remember taking this picture. It's just on his phone.
It's just from 2027. That's weird. I mean, I guess they could have, like, changed the date on it if they really wanted to. Like, I guess don't go on any planes in January 2027. That's what I would do, I guess, if that was some weird thing that just randomly showed up. So this one is a grisly story about some whatever. So I guess there's like a couple graves there, but I'll play it though so we can see what's happening here.
Marjorie McCall lived with her husband in Northern Ireland in the 1700s. She died of fever and was hastily buried to prevent the spread of it. She was buried with her wedding ring, which was known to be very valuable. Grave robbers found out about this and so dug up her coffin. They tried to remove the wedding ring from her, but they couldn't because her fingers had swollen considerably since death. They then decided to cut off her finger. As soon as blood was drawn, Marjorie came back to life. She wasn't actually dead, but was in a coma-like state. She then sat bolt upright and screamed. At home, her husband was sitting with their children and relatives. He then heard a knock at the door and said to his kids, "If your mother was still alive, I would swear that was her knock." Apparently, when he opened the door, he died of shock. He was then buried in the plot that Marjorie had recently vacated. She remarried and had several more kids. She eventually died for real, and her gravestone reads, "Lived once, buried twice."
The fuck? What even? Yeah, I'm not surprised that stuff like that would happen back whenever, because, you know, they didn't have very good whatever to tell if someone was dead or not, and now we do. Now we kind of have that thing to be like, yeah, this person's dead, or no, this person's not. I guess they just couldn't tell if someone was dead or not back then, because that was very common. They even had it where you could ring a bell to try to let someone know that you're still down there if you're actually, like, buried alive for whatever reason. So, yeah, there's a whole thing behind that. So this one says it's a Holy Land thing, and it's an abandoned Christian amusement park. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised, like, specifically a Christian thing being abandoned and scary. So, I don't know, but, like, I mean, abandoned stuff can be cool, but also kind of creepy at the same time, so I don't know. It's supposed to be like a cemetery thing there. Like, what the fuck? What is that even? Like, why though? It's like an amusement park? Or so-called amusement park thing? That's, like, why would that be an amusement park? What the fuck are Christians on to where they can call that an amusement park? I don't know. They're weird. So this one is a camping horror story thing, which a lot of people have had crazy shit happen when they're camping. So, not surprising.
Make it stop, am I real or just a prop? Oh,
what even? So they're just like throwing rocks and they carved a thing in the dirt there. Like, what the fuck? Like, maybe it could have been someone that actually was dangerous, or it was just some dumb kids being shitty, so I don't know. But yeah, that's like, what the fuck? This one is just called Vampires, so maybe they found vampires somewhere? I don't know.
Anyone,
oh, there's a thing of blood.
Their bag of AB blood just at the Baker Wetlands? Let me know.
What the fuck even? Why is there just a random little thing of blood there? That's, yeah, why? Okay, so I guess I'll just play this one because I don't know exactly whatever, but I guess it's a story time thing.
One time I was at an ASAP Rocky concert with like four other girls, and as we were leaving, these two guys walked up to us. They were like big ass guys. They were like, yo, let me get your number, blah, blah. And I was like, And the guy pulls out a track phone and gives me a track phone. So I put in my old phone number because I was like, I don't know, I'm not fucking with that. And they were like, let's just like, can't we get a ride home from you guys, blah, blah. And I was like, oh my god, we're like so drunk. Like, we're actually getting a ride home from like our mom, so we can't take you home, sorry. And this girl that I was with had no idea what was going on. She was like, what do you guys mean? I didn't drink anything tonight. And I was like, no, Becca, you're drunk, remember? So we start looping towards the fire station, and this guy starts calling somebody, and I was like, shit, he's trying to call my phone. Because I told him I was dead. And I hear him on the phone, and he goes, get here in 10. The bitch in front of me is walking damn fast. Me, I was the bitch in front of him. So I was like, and then he pulls me away from everyone and goes, what are you walking so fast for, Sasha? I didn't tell this man my name. Anyway, security ended up noticing, told the men to leave and escorted us to our car. And then my friend got 12 missed calls from a random number that night.
What the fuck? They somehow knew her name and then knew her friend's number. That's fucking sketchy as fuck. So I think this is just like, it looks like maybe it's just a joke thing of like if they were in the Saw movies or a Saw movie though, so I guess whatever. Maybe not really necessarily creepy, but just like a jokey thing about a creepy movie, I guess.
Maybe like, don't you guys think it's kind of sweet how much effort he put into this? Like, he thought through torture tactics that doubled as metaphors for things that have happened in our past and our personal lives. Oh my god. The little clown doll is wearing a tux. That is so darling. He had to have gotten that specially tailored.
Ugh, being kidnapped by a serial killer is such a bummer. Like, where's Dr. Spencer Reed when you need him? Can you guys at least pretend to laugh at my jokes? They make the situation like 100 times more bearable for me. Worst people to be kidnapped with. A bunch of people with no sense of humor.
Yeah, he said I was so annoying that I wasn't even fun to torture, so he just let me go. Like, all I was doing was singing Celine Dion while he was torturing me. Because I've always said that I wanted to die listening to Celine Dion so I could have my big, dramatic, cinematic ending that I deserve. It's not my fault he didn't have her greatest hit CD. I had to improvise.
Yeah, so it's just a joke thing there, so, you know. But still, I guess, whatever. Okay, so this one just has, like, a little gate thing here. It looks like maybe to a park or a cemetery, some kind of whatever woods area thing with a whatever pathway there. So yeah, I don't know, I guess.
This 1800s home reminds me of a vampire parlor.
It's an old house. As long as this isn't copyrighted, but I'm guessing it would be copyrighted music though, so that's a rip. But I don't know, whatever. But yeah, that's actually cool. I don't know why this is like on a creepy TikToks video. These kind of like stopped being scarier and creepy. They started to just get like, okay, that's cool, that's a funny joke video and whatever. But like, yeah, this cool little old house thing. It's not really creepy to me. So I don't know why this isn't here. I don't know why that other one was creepier in this creepy list either, because that was just a joke video about a movie thing, so I don't know where this list has gone. So yeah, that is it for this video. 30 creepy TikToks, or 39 or whatever, because one of them didn't work. So, whatever. But also, maybe more like 27 or 26, because a couple of them weren't actually scary. It was more like just a joke video and another video. It's like they didn't know what videos to put there in place of that. So they just picked a couple random ones that had to do with kind of creepy or gothic, kind of whatever, I don't know. But yeah, so I guess that's it for this video. If you want to at me in any TikToks and have it be in any videos, then yeah, you can at me in whatever, like ghost kind of ones, paranormal kind of TikToks, and be like, you know, stuff like that kind of thing. So yeah, anyways, I guess bye then.